This is Kat Fritz with Fast Pitch Prep, and today for Fast Pitch Tutor, we're going to be talking about throwing a curveball on a knee. So today when we're thinking about throwing a curveball on a knee, what we're trying to utilize here is we're thinking about our upper body and really stabilizing our upper body so that way we're nowhere in the right position to throw this pitch. Oftentimes when we're working on curveballs, I see a lot of this from young pitchers where they're rotating their shoulders and their arm comes away from their body, because they're trying to yank that pitch over or going across the plate. Where really we want to think about utilizing our wrist to move the ball instead of our shoulders. So think about if your body moves, then the ball is going to move drastically. And oftentimes we can't control that pitch as well as we want to. But if we utilize our wrist, we can control the specific how wide we want it to make it. So that's what we're going to be practicing here when we're on a knee, because we're already in a preset position to throw this pitch. So I've got my hips at 45 degree angles. I've got my front knee out a little bit. It's not stiff, and it's definitely not straight at 90 degrees, but nice and relaxed. And my front foot's at 45 degree angles as well. So when I'm thinking about this curveball, I'm going to get in whatever grip that you have for your pitcher to throw the curveball. I always threw it with the two skinny seams here. I had my ring finger and my middle finger on those seams, and my index finger is tucked nicely on the side. This is a Vance grip because I have a lot of strength in my wrist and my fingertips. If you have a pitcher who's just starting out this pitch, I would have them have the index finger on one of these two skinny seams and the middle finger on here. And you're thinking about taking these two fingers and twisting the ball around. So what I'm thinking about here is when I get to 2 o'clock, that's whenever my hand goes up, my palm goes up, and I'm starting to think my elbow comes in towards my hip and my wrist comes around the ball. Okay, so that's why we want to be in this position, because if I'm twisting too much with my body, there's no avenue for my wrist to come down and around my thigh. So that's why I want my hips open. When I go around to my circle, again, I've got my hand, as soon as I'm coming on my downswing, that's my wrist comes up, my elbow comes in towards my hip, and then I've got my fingertips going around the ball. So we're thinking about a nice sideways spin. It's going to look like this. Got here, nice and open, and follow through. Now, when I follow through, you can see my fingertips are nice and tucked into my front hip here. And my shoulders are nice and still staying open, because I'm really thinking about my wrist twisting around this ball to make it move instead of my shoulders, right? So again, coming here, twisting. And the ball will still spin, and you want to think about how many rotations can I get before it gets to my catcher. So a nice tight spin going sideways. If you have a loose spin, then the looser the spin is, the wider the pitch is going to be. And we don't want that, because that's harder to control. We want something, a pitch, this curveball, to break late whenever it gets to home plate. Because I'm close to my catcher, who's about 10 feet away, I'm not worried so much about it breaking right here, because I don't have my legs involved, I don't have my power involved to really make the pitch move. But here I'm working about, am I snapping at the right time, right before my hip? Is my follow through nice and tight to my body? Is my upper body in the right position? And then also, am I really spinning hard with this pitch? Do I have a lot of rotations? So again, nice and relaxed here, just working on the relaxed timing here. Up, perfect. And it should be a pitch that your catcher should be able to catch. He or she shouldn't be reaching across, because then we're missing our good window to release. So it needs to be right at the hip, following through at the front hip. So one more time here, just like that. And when she finishes, she needs to be upright. Again, shoulders need to be open, no crazy motion with my shoulders.